Do Jehovah's Witnesses celebrate Christmas? No, they do not. Even though the early Bible students did, which formed the basis of the JW religion, but then the latter-day JWs claimed they had to clean house with such old pagan practices that had nothing to do with Christianity and the birth of Christ. Jehovah's Witnesses claim that celebrating birthdays is a pagan practice, although they celebrate the first birth of a child, yet don't celebrate the first birth of Jesus Christ. They argue that you don't keep celebrating a child's first birthday throughout infinity. I know many online in various videos say that JW celebrate Christmas, but just not on December 25th, so as to not be a part of any so-called worldly pagan practice. But that's up to each individual JW whether or not their conscience allows them to celebrate Christmas in some form, as if to placate their unbelieving mates or relatives. This is normally true only for those who are married to unbelievers, meaning anyone not a baptized Jehovah's Witness. They try and celebrate Christmas on the down low and blame their worldly spouse if questioned by the elders in their congregation. Now, many people have used a shortened word for Christmas, which is spelled XMAS. So, how does the X stand for Christ or Christmas? Well, it doesn't. It stands for Nimrod. Have you heard about this in your Kingdom Hall? Have the elders talked about this in public talks? Well, not that I can remember. We were just basically told that the Catholics wanted to Christianize all the pagan non-believers, so they adapted all their holidays and Christianized them. They create a Christian story around a celebration so all the pagans would convert to Catholicism, then to other religions through the ages that worship the deity of Christ or Yahweh or whoever. Now, the JWs don't have any celebrations, again, only the first birth of a child and then wedding anniversaries. Anything else is basically frowned upon as supporting mainstream Christianity, when the JWs claim to be no part of Christendom with all their holidays. So where did Christmas come from? Well, Nimrod was born on December 25th, the high Sabbath of Babylon, and he was the founder of Babylon and the city of Nineveh. Nimrod stands unequaled for his symbolism of evil and satanic practices. He's credited for having founded Freemasonry and for building the legendary Tower of Babel in defiance of God's will. In Talmudic literature, he is noted as he who made all the people rebel against God. The legend of the Midrash recounts that when Nimrod was informed of Abraham's birth, he ordered all the male children killed to be certain of eliminating him. Abraham was hidden in a cave, but in latter life he was discovered by Nimrod, who then ordered him to worship fire. Abraham refused, and he was thrown into the fire. The legendary symbol for Nimrod is, yes, you guessed it, an X. The use of this symbol can denote witchcraft. When X is used as a shortened form meaning Christmas, it actually means to celebrate the feast of Nimrod. A double X, which has always meant to double cross or betray, in its fundamental meaning indicates one's betrayal into the hands of Satan. When American corporations use the X in their logo, such as Exxon, the historic Rockefeller firm and Standard Oil of New Jersey, there can be little doubt of this hidden meaning. The importance of Nimrod in any study of the occult cannot be overemphasized. Because of the powers given him by the clothing of Adam and Eve, Nimrod became the first man to rule the whole world. He indulged that power by launching excesses and horrors which have never been equaled. Nimrod introduced the practice of genocide. His grandfather Ham was persuaded by his consort, Naamah, to practice ritual murder and cannibalism. She informed Ham that by killing and eating fair-skinned people, his descendants could regain their superior qualities. I find it interesting. There's a movie out right now called Bones and All that has graphic portrayals of cannibalism. I suppose that is a last taboo to be exploited by mainstream Hollywood studios. Throughout the ensuing centuries, the fair-skinned descendants of Shem, Noah's oldest son, have ritually been slaughtered by descendants of Ham and Nimrod. Not only did Nimrod kill and eat the fair-skinned descendants of Shem, in his fury and hatred, he often burned them alive. The type of human sacrifice involving the eating of the slaughtered human victims derived its name from the combined names of his uncle, Canaan, and the demon god Baal, the two names being combined to form the word cannibal. Nimrod was also known in ancient history by the names of Marduk, Bel, and Merodach. Because of his importance in its history, Babylon was known as the land of Nimrod. Nimrod is also cited in the most ancient Masonic constitutions as the founder of Freemasonry. The source of this material is from The Curse of Canaan, A Demonology of History by Eustace Mullins. From The Two Babylons, or The Papal Worship Proved to Be the Worship of Nimrod and His Wife, written by the late Reverend Alexander Hislop. The festivals of Rome are innumerable, but five of the most important may be singled out for elucidation: Christmas Day, Lady Day, Easter, the Nativity of St. John, and the Feast of the Assumption. Each and all of these can be proved to be Babylonian. And first, as a festival in honor of the birth of Christ or Christmas. How come that festival was connected with the 25th of December? There's not a word in scriptures about the precise day of Christ's birth or the time of year when he was born. What is recorded there implies that at what time his birth took place, it could not have been on the 25th of December. At the time that the angel announced his birth to the shepherds of Bethlehem, they were feeding their flocks by night in the open fields. No doubt the climate of Palestine is not so severe as the climate of other countries, but even there, though the heat of the day can be considerable, the cold of night from December to February is very piercing. It was not the custom of the shepherds of Judea to watch their flocks in open fields later than about the end of October. How then did the Roman Church fix on December the 25th as Christmas Day? Long before the 4th century and long before the Christian era itself, a festival was celebrated among the heathen at that precise time of the year in honor of the birth of the son of the Babylonian Queen of Heaven. And it may fairly be presumed that in order to conciliate the heathen and to swell the number of the nominal adherents of Christianity, the same festival was adopted by the Roman Church, giving it only the name of Christ.
For more videos, don't forget to subscribe to this channel.